Well, hello YouTube, and welcome back to Retired for Life. So we're out in the bush today. The snow has been going back very quickly, so I've come down to bring in a couple of trail cameras, and we'll have a look at what's on those in another video. We're currently at the campsite, so you can see things are still, there's still a teeny bit of snow left, but not much. So I'm really looking forward to getting to work on this, but it is still too mucky. And I still have to concentrate on getting the sawmill running and getting through all those logs. Now, I've got one camera here that's been sitting pointed at the campsite because I did see some pretty interesting footprints in the snow here. So we're going to gather it up. And the other thing we're doing today is I have got a channel shout out I want to do for a really good channel. So stay tuned to the end of the video for that, and we'll get another sticker up on the sticker board. So let's head up Dragon's Back Hill here, and you may be able to see my one camera sitting right there. Now, very curious to see what's on this camera. It was an interesting spot to put it. But what I was seeing in the snow was tracks that came down over top of this hill into the little gully and then over top of this hill and down onto the trail here. And they went straight towards this camera. So hopefully we've got some interesting shots on it. Now what I want to do is once I check these cameras, I'm going to bring them out, relocate them, and I want to get two or three of the cameras actually away from the area that they're at right now because of the thousands of turkey picks that I keep getting on them. Oh my goodness. There is so many shots of turkeys. Anyway, they look happy and healthy. Okay, so we're gonna head back down Dragon's Back Hill here, get these cameras back to our little studio, see what's on them, and then get them back out here and get them in place. So stay tuned for the video that will be coming up shortly with what we find on the cameras. Oh, and I almost forgot. I did have a video out where I tried baiting one of my trail cameras to see what was going to turn up, hoping for some interesting footing. Well, unfortunately, it wasn't very interesting at all, so I just didn't bother with it. What happened was the fish fillets that I put out in front of the camera simply sat there for 2 days, and then a lone fisher showed up and swiped them away very quickly. So there was like two clips of this fisher picking up the fish fillets and disappearing. So, pretty boring, I'm afraid. Okay, folks, we are back out with the cameras. Working our way down through for a new location. Let's have a look around in this spot. Yeah, I mean, look at this. This definitely looks like a path. I think there is a real potential here. So what we're going to do is pick a tree and get our next camera up. I think that tree right there, that one. That one, I think, will do the trick very nicely. Now I'm thinking maybe I should put it over here on this tree. Yeah, let's do that. We'll put it over here. So I'm back here at the tree stand. Now, I have never actually come down to this part of the property before. And this is really interesting. I would say that that here is clearly a well-used path. Yeah. Look at that. That is definitely a used path. Let's just have a walk back in here for the heck of it. Yeah. Whoa. Look at all the deer scat. Oh, yes. And there is my fence line there. This looks really interesting. You know, I think I'm gonna go get my machete along with another camera and see if I can clear a spot so that I can catch the deer coming over the fence here. That would make for some really nice shots. All right, folks, let's do that. We're going to get gonna bring the machete down, another stand, and another camera, one of the good cameras. All right, that's the plan. Let's get to it. All right, camera location number 3, bottom of the hill, west of Sam's tree stand. All right, folks, so we're continuing along here. Now, this is a spot where a tree had come down, or a number of trees had come down and blocked my path. So I just finished clearing this out up through here with my little DeWalt battery-powered chainsaw. And the only thing left was a couple of limbs that were still across the trail, so I've cut them out. And I know it doesn't look like it on the camera, it never does, but this is extremely steep. There's one little bit of it that's almost straight up where the rocks are sticking out of the ground. So we are gonna go climb this and get to the top and do some more searching around for deer trails. All right, this should be interesting. That is quite the hill. All right, let's do a little walk around and see if we can find anything here. I'm seeing some scuff marks here, but no sign of scat at all. These trails, like there's a trail there, but I don't know what's using that. No sign of deer scat or bear scat or anything else. All right, I think we are gonna try to set up a trail camera here. Because I am seeing what looks like possible trails going down to the water, but I can't be sure. And it sure does look like a likely spot. All right, let's get back to the ATV and we'll grab a camera and a stand and we'll use this tree here. All right, camera location number 4. We are at the southwest corner of the property at the fence, by the fence line. So this camera is just about 20 feet past the north-south running fence and to the left of the east-west running fence or west running fence. All right, this is going to be the final location here. So I'm off on one of the new trails that I cut, kind of in the middle of the property. So we've got this big, or not that big of a maple tree here that is dead. Looking down the hill, you can see another real gnarly dead tree there. So I am going to set the camera up looking down into the ravine here. On this dead tree. It'll be interesting to see if there's anything going on down in the real thicker part of the bush here. All right. Let's get this camera in place. It is starting to cool off. So just down there, I can see the trail that goes back to the corner of the front yard. I'm gonna have to come out and give these things a GPS location or I will really have trouble finding them. Anyway, we'll get this last camera in place and then it's getting late and we're not too far from rain. So I think we'll need to head back for dinner. And then stay tuned for the sticker shout out at the end of this video. Well, that was a real nice time out on the trail. It really feels good to get back out there again and start hunting around. So we've got our cameras in place and looking forward to seeing what we capture from them. And stay tuned for the upcoming video showing the wildlife shots that I just got off of the cameras that we brought in today. That should be interesting to have a look at. So we're up by the sticker board or sticker door here on my shop. And I've got another sticker that I want to put out and a shout out. So today's shout out goes out to Vincent at Twin Brook Acres. So I've been following Vincent for a little while now. And the description for his channel reads, "My channel began as a place to post motorcycle riding videos, but quickly transformed into a channel for tractor projects and homesteading videos. We are in the Lakes region of New Hampshire. We bought our property, a former farm, with an early 19th century house and barn about 20 years ago, with plans to grow most of our own fruits and vegetables. As so often happens, life gets in the way, and we put any expectations on hold." Yeah, I know how that works. "We had blueberries, apple trees, blackberries, and cherry trees. We recently added a peach tree, another apple tree, grapes, and raspberries." Well, it sounds like that's really coming along. "We also now grow much of our own vegetables. Future expansion will include strawberries, watermelons, and pumpkins. You may still see the occasional motorcycle and aircraft video. So Vincent is obviously staying very busy, and right now he's working away at maple syrup. I watched a short video he just put out about that. I love maple syrup. He's also been having some fun dealing with flooding issues. Now, I know what that can be like. I've been playing games with that kind of thing myself. And Vincent's also been working hard on renovating this barn and putting a workshop in. And that's been quite a project. And the shop really looks great. You should have a look at it. So see the link to Vincent's channel in the description and let him know that Brian from Retired for Life sent you over. All right, let's get Vincent's sticker up here. Now, this is a real nice sticker. It's got the maple leaf on it. All right, there we are, Twin Brook Acres. So go have a look. So that's going to be it for today's video, folks. I hope you found it interesting, or at the very least, a little bit entertaining. And if you have, please don't forget to give it a like and share it around. And I'd love to have you subscribe to the channel. That would really help a lot. So remember to stay safe out there, be good to each other, and we'll see you out on the trails the next time. Yeah, it's gonna be a three-piece collection.